If you're developing a web API and if you try to run your API and you are getting this error, could not parse the JSON file, that's because when the host is trying to create or run the application, there is a problem in a specific file. Now let's check what's happening here. This line of code is trying to create the host where the application is going to reside, and after that it is going to run that application. Okay, it is calling this create host builder, and the host builder is trying to get the information about configuration for the application. Now let's check the starter file, and if you see here in this constructor, there is a variable, it's an object here with the name configuration, and it is assigning this configuration to this property. Okay, this configuration object is getting information about, for example, string connections or logging, how it's going to work with login, and or any other information that the application is going to need. Okay, and we can find that information in this file, the upsetting file, and we need to have a correct structure in this file, or it is not going to be correct, and we are going to have that error. And if we check the structure for this file, we can see all the brackets open and close, for example, open close, but we have an additional bracket here, so I'm going to remove it. Okay, and I'm going to try to run again the app, and now it's running. Okay, for that reason you have to pay attention to the file structure, to brackets, commas. For example, if I remove a comma here, I'm going to get the same error, but that's different. Okay, but the message is going to be the same at the top. Could not parse the JSON file. And well, especially if you modify the file, I'm going to create a new value for me. It is going to be my value, my key in this case, and my value. Now, try to verify that everything is okay. Run the app. And as you can see, there is not any error. And I'm going to get the information from this key. I'm going to use the configuration file. And using the object for the configuration, I'm going to get the value. Get value. I have to specify what's the type. It's going to be a string because this is a string, and I have to specify the string key. It's the key, it's my key. I'm going to assign the value to a variable, my key, I'm going to set the breakpoint and to run again. Let's verify what value we're going to get. My key, and as you can see, it has my value. Okay, so this is the way how you can resolve this problem.